One of the most interesting elements of being at MacDowell is the tombstones. They're these wooden boards that everyone who comes, each person that stays in one of the studios, one of the artists, signs their name to show that they were here, to leave some trace of their existence. The part that's interesting is that the tombstones are preserved in each studio. They sit and wait for more people to come, and over time, there are tens of them, you know, tombstone after tombstone, from the very recent to the very old. And I have a tombstone right here from my studio. This is a tombstone. And you can see here, this is it from Schelling. And you can see at the top, we have Jonathan Franzen, and then Sandra Singlow, and then many other people. And some people use shiny things and crazy things. And my friend Lisa D'Amore is somewhere along here. And I don't recognize most of these names. And as you look at the older ones, they get fainter and fainter. The letters fade away entirely. And you don't even have to go back that far to start losing track of who's who. It takes suspiciously little time, you know. Go back 15, 20 years and I don't know who these artists are, you know, except for the rare superstar who's leaping out of the firmament. It's a wonderful metaphor, the very best kind of metaphor, a metaphor made manifest, you know. It stands on the walls to tell you, we are the ones who have sat here before you. We thought and lived in these spaces, and some of us are still alive, and some of us, most assuredly, are dead. But we were like you. We were like you, and some of us became famous, and many of us did not. In the end, it has nothing to do with that. I like them. I think it's a wonderful tradition. It's the best kind of tradition, the kind where you can taste death right on it, where you can feel the metaphor rising up out of the symbol itself. It's the kind that really means something.